increase the prices of electric vehicles, and therefore people won't want to buy them. Yeah, yeah. And it's cyclical, as you can see.
Yeah, this morning, and so she said, can I come to work with you? And I said, sure. And so I generally make a bagel, and I wake up really early and have my bagel with cream cheese and my coffee. And she said, you know there's a shortage of cream cheese?
Yes.
I said, cream? There's a shortage of cream cheese?
Yes. New York specifically, if you go to a bagel shop in New York, there is a chance they will not have your cream cheese.
What the hell to do?
What?
Let's take a break. And we'll come back and finish up Dr. Seuss' book of his entire collective works. Green bagels and cream cheese?
What the hell to do? The U.S. is considering new sanctions on Myanmar. Secretary of State Blinken said today the situation there has gotten worse since the military overthrew the civilian government in February. The Navy tested a laser weapon and destroyed a floating target in the Mideast. The USS Portland test-fired a laser weapon system demonstrator yesterday. The Navy's Mideast-based 5th Fleet is described as having successfully engaged the target. And another deadline's here to make sure all those packages get delivered on time for Christmas. Today is the last day for ground service with FedEx and the Postal Service. We've got your Drive on the 5 with VKFI in the Sky next.
When Bill and I needed new windows over 20 years ago, we picked a company we thought would do a good job. We were so disappointed.
So we saw a genuine need for a company with strong character, one that people could have faith in.
American Vision Windows was born right then and there.
The best thing about working for American Vision Windows and the customer specifically is having their dreams come true. And we try to accomplish the best job we can to make them happy.
It was a great experience. I couldn't ask for anything better.
I've been in the construction trade for 35 years. The level of quality of products that they use for their prep work was top notch.
American Vision Windows continues to revolutionize the home improvement industry, one customer at a time, while changing the lives of our employees for the better. It's so simple.
Happy employees, happy customers.
For a limited time, we pay the tax, plus zero payments, zero interest until 2023. Call 888-226-9908. That's 888-226-9908, or visit AmericanVisionWindows.com.
Tax based on materials only. On purchase of 8 or more windows, cannot be combined with any other offers. On approved credit, some restrictions apply. See website for details. Offer expires 12/31/2021. CSLB number 778326.
Prime members, take your holiday feast to the next level at Whole Foods Market. Save 25% on sustainable wild-caught previously frozen lobster tail through December 25th at select stores while supplies last. See more on the Whole Foods Market app.
SoCal weather from KFI, mostly sunny today with highs in the 50s. This report is brought to you by Whole Foods Market. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy. We got your Drive on the 5.
Well, we sure do. A little bit of an issue now. We're headed towards Burbank Airport, north by Alameda, just a little bit north of the 134. It's been a crash in the center divider. It's going to cause a little bit of slowing, no question about it. But after that, you should be in good shape right up to the U-Haul Pass. And a problem that was just getting word of now, coming through Calabasas, or two, maybe I should say, the westbound 101 at Moreau, that's the top of the hill, past Parker, Calabasas, crash in the center divider, that's going to get a lot of attention as well. Downtown Los Angeles, some good news, finally, north 110 at the Ford, although there's a problem there, it's definitely slow from third, the collector lane's going through. Orange County Drive, north 5, it's okay, a little slow north of the 91, usual stuff. After that, you'll be okay to the interchange and the big westbound drives now. The West 210, 10 to 60 now, 57 over 605. 210 definitely slow. It always is, but kind of normal stuff. The 60 is still in pretty good shape. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Jeff Baugh.
This report is sponsored by 1-800-NO-CUP Criminal Defense.
Hey, it's Darren Cavanocchi, founder of 1-800-NO-CUPS, wishing you a happy holidays. We hope you never need us, but if you get into trouble, call 1-800-NO-CUPS, because no one looks good in handcuffs, even during the holidays. 1-800-NO-CUPS.
The problem with New Year's resolutions? They're hard to keep, and not so much fun. But if you're looking to make better financial decisions in the New Year, here's a radio show that can help you get there, and if you arrive. Tune in the weekend of June 9th to the premiere of Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chapman, presented by Edelman Financial Engineers. Each week, award-winning journalist Soledad O'Brien and personal finance expert Gene Chapman will explore how our financial decisions shape our everyday lives and why wealth is about more than just money. They'll be joined by Edelman Financial Engine's wealth planners and other guests. to help demystify challenges like generational planning, retirement income, and tax-efficient investing. New episodes of Everyday Wealth will air every weekend and will be available on major podcast platforms. For airtime, visit everydaywealth.com.
Well, holiday shopping season again. Not many more shopping days to decide what I should buy myself. And now, the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
Get the gift of good times. You'll find a new slot or table game around every corner at Morongo. Surprise, you've already won.
Number four.
Gift a day giveaway. You'll get gifts Monday through Friday till December 21st when you earn 500 points on your rewards card.
Three.
Christmas Day dining deals. From Cielo to Good Time Cafe, we've got deals from the clouds to the casino floor.
And the number two,
Christmas Day freebie. Get a fancy Christmas grouch Christmas Day.
And the number one reason,
12 Days of Fabio. 60 winners in 12 days will win one of Fabio's kitchen essentials. Go to MorongoCasinoResort.com to register today.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good time!
Can you believe the holidays are almost here? When you think about that, what's the first thing that comes to mind? For me, it's the smiling faces of friends and family as we celebrate together. I'm Larry Green of System Tailors, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. Today, I'd like to help bring a smile to you and your loved one's faces, too. For a limited time, System Tailors is sharing our exclusive friends and family prices. This is your chance to save big on an outdoor makeover that will make every get-together more memorable than ever. From a new patio or fire pit to upgrading your driveway or entry, take advantage of the low prices during our Home for the Holidays Friends and Family Savings event. Get started right now by calling 800-PAGE-004. That's 800-PAGE-004. How do you get exclusive friends and family pricing won't last forever. 800-PAGE-004 or SystemTailors.com.
All orders must be placed by December 31st and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. Financing subject to third-party approval. See website for full offer details. Contact advisors 661-575.
We have a lot to celebrate this holiday season. But COVID-19 hasn't gone away. So let's make sure to keep our celebration safer by following these tips. Get vaccinated to protect loved ones and get a booster to keep your immunity strong. Wear a mask in it to protect you and others. And if possible, keep gathering small, short, and outdoors if you're uncertain of everyone's vaccination status. Bring on the cheer safely this year. Find a vaccine near you at myturn.ca.gov. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Having efficient equipment is essential to operating your small business.
SoCal Gas is here to help with small business rebates on qualifying energy-saving natural gas equipment. You can save up to $1,000 on tankless hot water heaters, commercial fryers, and more.
They're committed to helping you meet and exceed the challenges of being a small business owner.
Not only will your small business save by using these rebates, but you have energy-efficient equipment that could stack up savings for years to come. See how they can help by visiting SoCalGas.com/business rebates.
Between selling drugs and stealing and fencing,
it's a good thing to be a gang member right now.
All you have to fear are the other gangs, but you don't have to fear the police.
Police aren't going out there to enforce anything right now.
You have the store owners that are beaten down and disillusioned, so the guy running Target, he's not going to bother anymore. John and Ken.
We did it too on KFI.
I'm wanting for
KFI AM 640 on a really cold Wednesday, December 15th. Handle and the morning crew as we finish Handle on the news. Jennifer Jones Lee, Wayne, and me.
And the state of Kentucky now is going to look into that candle factory where the workers say that they were threatened with firing. Now, OSHA also said yesterday that they were threatened with firing if they did go home before the storm hit. So that's one of the allegations that came out. I guess now they've got to figure out, is there proof of that? Does somebody have a memo that says that happened?
But even if there is, what is, number one, where's the criminality? It doesn't exist. And in terms of lawsuit, where's the connection? I don't think there is either, because they're going to argue we're actually the safest place to be. And if there's any proof of that, much more than just a home. And who can anticipate a tornado going through and flattening it on that level? This is the biggest tornado on record.
What if the timing had to do with it? Like, they were able to say, hey, if Joe Blow came to me at 6 o'clock and said, hey, I really want to get out of here. And they said, no way, you'll get fired if you do. 8 o'clock comes around, and the tornado hits, and, you know, Joe is dead now.
Yeah, but that's, an hour, they say, that's hours later. You
but
have
that's
to,
the point, that you Joe have to could connect. Have left at 2 hours ago and gotten away from the storm.
And go with, well,
very speculative.
Very speculative, yeah.
It would have been safer. And the thing, I guess the point is there a specific labor law that says when a storm is coming?
No, of course
you
not.
Have to let people no. choose where they shelter
yeah,
in place?
I think it's very speculative.
And by the way, I don't like it. I mean, assuming this happened, I don't like it, but I don't know legally what avenues
I don't think
there
so.
Are.
Yeah, I don't think so. And even the governor told reporters at a news conference that as we look into it, that there shouldn't suggest that there was any wrongdoing on their part. We just want to look into this and try to figure out what happened. That's
and,
it.
And OSHA is investigating this one. They're investigating Illinois, the Amazon factory. I mean, they'll go through anytime there's a death at a workplace.
Sure.
That's what they do.
Sure.
I don't know if you heard this, but there was a little rain in the Southland yesterday, and at least 3 cars ended up in the L.A. River. Including the situation where a car went in and got trapped against a column, and then apparently another car got in the river and ended up coming and hitting that car, and they were like wedged together in the raging river, which how often do you get to say the LA River was raging with water?
Almost never. Jen was doing this story, I think, in real time as it was happening. It's basically at the same point. They don't know if anybody was even in those cars.
And the weirdest part about it was that the river was raging so badly that the fire crew said they looked down at this car in there and they said, well, that's a recovery.
Right. Couldn't do anything about it. Assuming there's someone in the car.
Right.
It could have been a car that was just swept in.
Parked car just got moved over.
All right, police have arrested a suspect who is accused of kidnapping 2 kids in his SUV. And this was on Tuesday night. They rescued the 2 young kids after there was a pursuit through South L.A. And at one point during the pursuit, the suspect apparently dodged a spike strip and then ended up in the driveway of a home. And they saw him get out of the car, pull one of the kids out of the car before getting back in. And then a short time after stopping, the driver was taken into custody. One kid was rescued from the SUV by the officers, but both ultimately are okay.
Yeah, and we don't know the connection either.
No.
And I'm sure there is some, because the vast majority of kidnapping circumstance like this is a parent, usually a father, who grabs the kid. So we don't know it.
Well, how free is O.J. Simpson now? 100% free. His parole ended on December 1st. We're just hearing about it now. There you go. Zero obligation to the criminal justice system, right?
Where does he stand with the money that he's supposed to pay to the Goldman family?
Well, he's never going to pay it. That money comes in from his pension. That's where he survives on, his NFL pension, which is pretty healthy. And that can't be touched. When you have a judgment, pensions cannot be touched.
So even though the judgment was $33.5 million against him to that family, they won't see it?
No. I mean, they sold a couple of things. They grabbed his Heisman trophy and a few other things, but that's about it. They'll never see it. And by the way, can you imagine what it's like now with interest? Because interest builds up.
Sure.
It doesn't matter, though, how big a bill is if you're never going to pay it.
No.
All right, and let's see. Well, let's do... A woman is... she got 5 years... for panhandlers killing cover stories. So she helped her dad cover up his wife's murder in 2018, and she said that it was a knife-wielding panhandler who had killed his wife, and now she's been sentenced to that panhandler was sentenced to up to 5 years in prison. She pleaded guilty now, saying that, yes, she acted as an accessory after the murder of Jacqueline Smith, saying she ditched her stepmom's purse at a bus stop to help make the panhandler story viable.
She got 5 years, but Wayne, she's already been locked up 3 years.
Right.
And so, assuming that she has good time behavior, she is off, half of the sentence. She walks out the door, doesn't she?
Yeah, she'll be out very soon. Now, the husband who actually killed his wife is looking at life in prison.
Yeah. Because I'm assuming killing your spouse is a pretty serious charge.
It's more serious than helping someone lie about how the wife died.
Although I must tell you, you want to be in front of a judge that's going through a vicious divorce.
Oh.
You know what? That is terrible, but also there is some truth to that. There is some truth to that. Judges do bring their personal lines to the bench.
Remember DeLorean, who was acquitted? And, I mean, they had him on tape, on video, selling half a kilo of cocaine to the FBI, undercover agents. I mean, there was right there, and he was acquitted. Why? One of the biggest reasons is he had the only federal judge in the system who had been interned as a child at an internment camp here in California. Yep. And let me tell you, he did not trust the government very much. He was known as an anti-government judge. At least that don't do that. Don't correct me. It's a good story.
Well, no, I'm just saying, I don't know that he was anti-government, but he was very open to any claim of government misconduct, like the DeLorean they were saying
it was set up
and all this stuff.
Yeah.
And he would be one who'd be like, yes, I'm very much listening to this. Whereas other judges would be like, no, the government didn't do anything wrong. Get out of here.
Okay, so that's
a good judge.
So that's 90% backing up my story. I'll take it.
Yes, I am backing up.
I really
think. He didn't come in and go, apropos of nobody saying anything, I don't trust the government.
No, I understand that. I mean, that would be, that's appealable, I would think.
Yes.
Okay, coming up, we are done with the news. Coming up, the LAPD used what is called strategic communication. And what does that mean and what it's about? Well, it's a privacy issue. And I'm going to tell you what some completely crazy people that are arguing against the LAPD have been saying. This is KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Yeah, who am I fooling? Next year's going to suck too.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Mask it up. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Face masks are once again required in all indoor public spaces in California, even if people have been vaccinated. State health officials reinstated the mask mandate because of rising cases of COVID-19. The statewide mandate will be in place until at least January 15th. Public health officials in LA County say cases of the Omicron variant of COVID have officially doubled in the county. There are now 8 more known cases. A person in Pasadena is said to have been infected locally. Officials say the person was fully vaccinated and got a booster. News is brought to you by Tough Turtle Turf. 3 people have been hurt in a shooting at Del Amo Mall in Torrance. Cops say 2 or 3 people started shooting at about 6 last night and that the shooting does not appear to be random. California Attorney General Rob Bonta says he's been told smash-and-grab robberies in the L.A. area work for much larger criminal groups than have been around for a while. Bonta met with local business leaders and law enforcement about the rise in commercial robberies.
We need to hold folks who commit these types of serious, brazen crimes responsible. Hold them to account. And we are.
Bonta says the meeting yesterday is one of many to exchange information, ideas, and strategies to respond and prevent smash-and-grabs. LA County Sheriff Dina Hueva says because of continued budget cuts, it's going to be difficult to provide security at major events.
Those events include the upcoming Rose Parade, the Super Bowl, even the Olympics in 2028.
A lot of these we're assisting the city of Inglewood, we're assisting the city of Pasadena, and the Summer Olympics. This one is going to be just ginormous. That's 690 deputies we need daily throughout the course of the Olympics.
The Board of Supervisors says the department is properly funded, but Villanueva says the board hasn't factored in raises, union and city contracts, and inflation. The sheriff says he's down 1,281 positions. Chief Gregory, KFI News.
A lawyer says a 19-year veteran deputy has been unfairly charged with throwing what was meant to be lukewarm water on an inmate's hands. Orange County DA spokeswoman Kimberly Edge says the deputy has been charged with felony assault by public officials and felony battery.
There's absolutely no evidence that that water was lukewarm. It was scalding enough to burn this mentally ill inmate's hands and leave his skin peeling off.
The lawyer says the charges send the wrong message to officers who are trying to find alternatives to physical force. The deputy was fired Friday and is due in court next month. The LA School District's recently selected superintendent says he wants to expand educational outreach for parents.
Activities are specific to communities with community participation, philanthropic support, business support at no cost to the taxpayer that would lead to the nation's largest parent academy.
Alberto Carvalho says he also wants to expand public education choices for students in LA. Orange County's approved using more than $34 million in state funds to turn three more motels into 180 units of homeless housing.
The money will be used to buy, renovate, secure, and maintain the three properties, which are in Stanton, Huntington Beach, and Costa Mesa.
If there's anything that was good that came out of the COVID pandemic, it was Project Home Key.
Supervisor Lisa Bartlett says the state project was first designed to just get people off the streets during the pandemic while filling old vacant PD motels.
It covers all the bases. It covers those that are homeless, those that are at risk for homelessness. It covers units for veterans and for seniors.
The county already has 132 units at two properties through Project Home Key. In Orange County, Corbin Carson, KFI News.
And the House has voted to hold former White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows in contempt of Congress for not cooperating with the committee investigating the attack on the Capitol. The vote yesterday sends the matter to the U.S. Attorney's Office for possible criminal charges. Let's get a look at your drive now on the 101.
You bet you. This is Calabasas. Good morning. Thanks for letting us ride along with you. Now, if you're with us last time around, now westbound 101 up Moreau is talking about a possible problem right at the top of the hill, right at the overpass. That's pretty much cleared by CHP. So if there is a problem a little bit farther west at Las Virgenes, some debris. So just be careful going up and over that hill and going out to this Lost Hill. Back to Burbank, North 5 Alameda, Burbank Boulevard, possibly white pickup truck in lane. Trying to get that clear. It's a little slow coming up from the 134. Not too bad. I have to warn you about a South 605 problem now. If you're coming down from the 60, still in pretty good shape by getting slow at Washington. The problem is roads, friends. The roads are bright to clear a lot of debris. There's debris all over the place, so just be careful. After that, you'll be okay. And real quick to the mountains, Highway 38, San Bernardino, closed from Bryant Street to Lake Williams Drive, as is Angeles Crest, closed at Angeles Park. It's going to be a tough morning. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Jeff Ball.
The Lakers are at the Dallas Mavericks at 4:30 today, looking to extend their win streak to three, but they'll be without Talen Horton-Tucker, who entered the league's health and safety protocols yesterday, causing a cancellation of practice. The Clippers play the Jazz in Utah at 7. You can hear it live on AM 570 LA Sports. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports.
If you thought you missed the lowest mortgage rates in history, you're in luck, because they're back. Mortgage rates are near historic lows again. So if you have a mortgage, refinance it and forget it. You'll never have to worry about refinancing again. Network Capital Funding is offering a low 15-year fixed rate at 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Incredible! Network Capital has built a reputation for saving people time and money with our unique process that's fast, simple, and secure. Our 15-year fixed rate is 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Now, second chances don't come often, and you may never see these rates again. So, refinance it and forget it. That's a 15-year fixed at 1.75%. Yes, 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Call the experts at Network Capital now. Call 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1-HIT. As in home run. Call now and save big on your refi. 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1448.
NMLS ID 11712. Not licensed in all states. Visit NMLSConsumerAccess.org. Licensed by the California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation. Under the financing law. Number 603-87. An equal opportunity lender. Rates subject to change and may not be available rate law. Discount points may apply. Subject to credit approval. Call 800-500-1448.
Today is the day. It's the day you make something huge happen. Today's the day you call the weight loss experts at West Medical. From your first nervous call to your very first time you hear, oh my God, you look amazing, they got you. Look, weight loss procedures are covered by most PPO insurance, but coverage is changing all the time. So lock in your benefits now. Today is your day to call 1-800-WESTMED or visit westmedical.com for a free consultation.
I feel incredible because I called 1-800-WESTMEDICAL.
Your results will vary depending on procedure selected and adherence to program.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is down 104, S&P down 10, NASDAQ down 69, and the average price of a gallon of unleaded gas in California also down. It's $4.67.
Bay Alarm security systems can change with your business, so you're right for now and ready for the next.
Mostly sunny today. Highs will be in the mid to upper 50s. We do have a high surf advisory till 2 this afternoon and a slight chance of rain tomorrow. Right now it's 37 in Orange, Laguna Beach, and in Baldwin Park. 39 in Pacoima. We lead local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
AM 640, Bill Handel here. Really cold Wednesday morning, December 15th. Yeah, winter is here. 35 degrees outside. I actually had ice on my windshield this morning. A couple of big stories that we're carrying. Yesterday it was announced that the LA Unified School District will not enforce the student vaccine mandate until next fall.
They've moved it ahead. Why? Well, because we've got 87% have been vaccinated, which means, 13% have not. That's a lot of students. And the school is simply overwhelmed with the alternative program that they have set up not the in-person, but online program that they have to have. So they've done, okay, we're taking it. And the same thing we reported yesterday with the nurses all over the country. Hospitals are now saying, okay, mandate's over. We need nurses more than we need, effectively people dying of COVID. Hey, we'll take that as long as we have nurses. I'm exaggerating, obviously. There was and is a public records request by the Brennan Center for Justice. And they asked for public records were asking about what the LAPD was doing. And here is what they were doing, the LAPD. Is there was a one-month test, it's about a Polish firm with no law enforcement experience helping the LAPD collect thousands of tweets related to just some search words or words that were used in tweets and emails, etc. And a lot of it related to Black Lives Matter, racial justice protests. But to find out who is talking about it and then investigating and maybe following up. We don't know what the LAP did with that information, but I'll tell you what they did do. This is during the fall of 2020. The company Edge NPD tracking tweets on roughly 200 keywords for the police department, and they collected millions of tweets. Tens of thousands of them related to the Black Lives Matter movement, racial justice protests, some from prominent Black activists outside of L.A., private citizens advocating for reforms. And what the LAPD was interested in, this is pursuant to the record, is the company was helping them respond to negative narratives and aiming to flag possible threats. The good news for civil libertarians and people who are First Amendment folks, that the LAPD did not pursue the permanent contract, decided not to do it. One of them is because there was so much data. What do you do with millions of tweets? But the problem is, law enforcement agencies across the country have been forced to take their investigations online and have sought tools to do exactly that. So tech companies are, of course, responding, showing new innovations, pursuing police contracts, which, incidentally, LAPD in New York are the biggest customers, because they have the biggest budgets, and they can do that. A small police department can't do that. So it was a 40-day trial. In October and November, November of 2020, we just found out about it because of the request for documents. And the company provided the police department with a dashboard monitoring tweets related to six topics. One, civil unrest, then American policing, domestic extremism, white nationalism, election security, potential danger, and the conflict between Armenia and Azerbaijan, which at the time we have a large Armenian population here. 200 possible keywords on top of that. LAPD Chief Moore, abolish the police, no justice, no peace, police budget, police killing, among others. And LAPD agreed that it would be good to monitor, but there are so many people, legitimate people, using those terms, it just went nowhere. Because the algorithm just wasn't that sophisticated, and still isn't. And the problem becomes that, for example, keywords, domestic terrorism, extremism, racist. How many people talk about racism? And who goes through all of these tweets? And one of the civil libertarians points out, no one describes themselves as a domestic extremist or describes themselves as a supremacist of any kind. They're just patriots who are bringing America back to where it should be. And that is the problem. And incidentally, on this one, LAPD has faced racial profiling scandals over the years. It really has had big trouble. So, one of them is defund the police. And we're not talking about extremism or threats. It's just people want to defund the police.
Sorry,
and they're following
no,
those people.
Sorry.
I mean, that's the thing that's crazy.
Sorry.
So, unfortunately, that is... fortunate. I don't even know how I feel about that, because I have no problem policing people. I mean, after the Boston Marathon bombing, anybody who was even looking for a pressure cooker instantly got a visit from the FBI. Hey, what are you doing? I'm looking for a pressure cooker because I want to cook with a pressure cooker. Do we have a problem with that? But that's the fear. And today, I mean, the same thing goes with keywords like extremism or, I guess, terrorism. Even if they're looking at it, even if we're looking at it, say the producer, let's say Morgan or Alex, I want to do a story on extremism. So we're going through the whole thing and all the research is being done. That would pop up instantly. So there's some issues there. Anyway, the contract was never signed. It was a trial for 40 days. The shrinking of the Build Back Better Act. Joe Biden's act on which it's a social spending act, and we'll talk about that. It's collapsing. So still be there, but it ain't what it used to be, Joe. We'll be back. This is KFI AM 640, and let's check in with Jennifer.
A former Netflix executive has been sentenced to more than 2 years in federal prison for taking bribes and kickbacks from tech companies to approve millions of dollars in contracts. Michael Kale also has forfeited $700,000. Some investors are enjoying the brief moment they became quadrillionaires, at least on paper. Happened yesterday because of a problem displaying cryptocurrency quotes online. And Time Magazine's Person of the Year, Elon Musk, is clapping back at Massachusetts Senator Elizabeth Warren. Musk would have to pay taxes and stop freeloading. Musk tweeted, Warren should stop projecting, criticized her claims of American ancestry, and compared her to a friend's angry mom when he yelled at everyone for no reason. We got your drive on the 605 with DKFI in the sky next.
Rates subject to change without notice. Term restrictions and minimum loan amount requirements apply. 60% LTV and 625 FICO score. Subject to credit approval by refinancing your existing loan. Your total finance charges may be higher over the life of the loan. Bank MLS 3290. Change made arrange. Pursuant to California Financing Law License. Number 6023-6970. Equal housing number.
You asked for a holiday song. That hit me at home with a brand new fashion date. You got a new home run. That's really, really great. In Caroline today, you're going to count the price.
The weather is brought to you by Hastings Market. We're up to your drive in the 605.
It is beautiful.